Hey guys, what's up? It's Simba here. Thank you so much for joining me on the Vision Board podcast.
Hey guys, welcome to the Vision Board podcast. This guest does not need any introduction. I want to say that when I started this whole podcast thing, I went to this gentleman for advice, and still to this day, he still provides value and he's still killing it. He has a new film out. Let me not talk about it. Let me just bring him on here. Alex, welcome to the Vision Board podcast. How are you doing?
My man, thank you for having me. I'm doing good.
Yeah, for sure. So, you're the reason I started podcasting, man. Thank you for inspiring me. And what you been up to, I guess? That's my question I want to start off with.
Man, first of all, I'm humbled. When starting the podcast, I think that was my initial goal was to just inspire others to kind of lean into themselves and try to figure out, you know, what they wanted and how they could do it. And I hoped that by trying to figure out on my own and documenting it as I was doing it, that other people would feel comfortable doing that too. So, like, you know, I'm incredibly humbled and I'm glad to see that you're doing your own thing too.
Appreciate it. Yeah, you were on Marlo's podcast, and I want to say that was really informative. I got to know about your business, the family business, and what you your previous business, and you do a lot. You got a film, Coaching While Black. How did that start, and can you just like let people know like what the film is about as well?
Honestly, everything for me goes back to my podcast. If I didn't start my podcast, you know, I don't come into contact with Don Phillips, the gentleman who we documented in the film. Mm-hmm. So, you know, starting the podcast was kind of the breeding ground for all the other ideas. I was, I started out like in modeling and stuff like that.
Okay.
And we know it's a shallow industry, and I was trying to break into, you know, film and television. And so that was the only way I figured that I could put my thought out there, you know, and also get to know other people and other people's experiences, journeys, and things of that nature. And, you know, one thing kind of led to another, led to the you know, Collective for Black Iranians, led to Coaching While Black. Mm-hmm. And so now I'm trying to go full-time with this filmmaking thing. I feel like I have something to say, and you know, I'd like to find, you know, an artistic medium to do it, and I think film is the best way to do that.
Exactly. So guys, his podcast name is TheGiftedGab. His co-host is Andre Kelly, and y'all check out TheGiftedGab. Also, he has a clothing brand under the podcast. I mean, the podcast is really the whole the stem, and is the real foundation to your story and your upcoming and just who you are. I mean, which guest, I guess the first question I want to say is your biggest aha moment in your podcast. What would you say that is, Alex?
Biggest aha moment?
Mm-hmm.
I think the biggest aha moment for me was just sticking with the podcast. You know, I have 6 or 7 episodes in, I started seeing kind of how powerful podcasting was, mm-hmm. In terms of the opportunities it was bringing, because it was exposing me to new people. It was exposing me to new networks. It was exposing other people to me. And so a lot of the connections that, you know, I've been able to create through the podcast have been so fruitful in so many new ways. And the biggest aha moment for me was just in the middle of the podcast. I'm like, I gotta keep doing this. I gotta figure out how to keep doing it. I gotta figure out how to stay sharp, how to improve the craft. And when me and Andre started it, me and Andre didn't really have our own paths.
Yeah.
We were just like, let's create this brand you know, let's create this podcast and just, you know, inspire other people through other people's stories. You know what I'm saying? And hopefully in that process, we would find our own. And then since then, you know, Andre has, you know, he went into acting and now he's a full-time actor. He just finished his program at Humber College and he's busy acting, you know? And so for me, I found a path in like filmmaking and producing. And so podcasting is producing, you know? So I kind of already had an idea of how what goes into a production. And so when it was time to do a film, a documentary film at that, I felt prepared. I felt like, okay, this is challenging, but I could do it. And it's opened up other doors for me now. So I'm trying to figure out ways to just keep the ball rolling. And the Gifted Gab for me and Andre, like, we're still doing it, but we're in a process of reimagining what that looks like and rebranding and bringing on more creators and more voices and more stories. So
I love that. I mean, you touched on, like, you know, your co-host doing acting and you got your rebranding. I mean, that's so important. I want to say, like, would you think about doing, like, would you start doing something like outside of like Canadian Talent? Are you guys trying to rebrand into like a different logo? Like, what does that even look like? Because me myself, I have a podcast as well. I'm thinking about doing season two, maybe, like, you know, in person, like kind of sort of similar to what you guys are doing, bringing people in a space and inviting them that way. But I don't know, what does rebranding look like for you?
Well, for us, we wanted to always inspire, right? And it didn't have to be us inspiring. It was other people's stories, right?
Exactly.
And so, you know, me and Andre sat one day and we're like, you know, how do we keep doing what we do, but removing ourselves as the faces? And that's kind of what the rebrand is about. Because I think when we started, we're like, okay, like, we'll be the face of it. We'll do this day out. And we learned a lot about ourselves through that process. But now we're like, you know, we still want to do the same thing. We still want to inspire. We still want to do the storytelling. We still want to have conversations, but we want to remove ourselves from that spotlight so that other people can have that, you know, opportunity to meet, you know, to create a voice for themselves, right? And so because me and Andre have already done it, and I think we benefited tremendously from it, we want to repackage it in a new way so that, you know, we're getting to know other creators, we're getting to know other faces, new co-hosts. And me and Andre will still be on the interviewing side, but we want to kind of minimize us on screen and make the platform bigger than me and him, you know. So
got it. So basically you guys bringing on, hiring other people, like hosting the show, but it's like bigger than you and Andre. It's like a whole community. So that's never thought you could do that. Okay. I want to obviously ask, like, any advice you'd have for someone trying to do exactly what you're trying to do, the podcast industry, the entertainment, the whole business side of things. And like, what would you advise them to do, Alex? Like, because you're already in it. You know what to do, what not to do. Like, what would you advise these new cats coming into the game? What would you advise them to do?
I think first of all, vision board podcast. A vision board is so crucial. It's been crucial to my success. Just having, you know, your goals on a board in front of you makes it so real. Like, if you look at my office, I painted my walls with whiteboard paint so that I could just write on the walls. That was something, like, you know, me and Andre started, you know, we would sit, we would brainstorm, and we would just put it on a whiteboard, you know, and then it's like, okay, now you have these goals. I think, like, whatever it is that you decide to do, stick with it until you're sick of it, you know? And I don't mean, like, I think the magic number for podcasting is seven. Like, most podcasts, they don't make it past seven episodes. So if you made it past seven, like, you're in a different bracket, and you just have to keep going. Like, me and Andre, we tried so hard to be consistent, and it was difficult because we were in the middle of learning how to make a podcast. Like, we didn't know how to do it. I think our first 10 episodes, it took us, you know, 50, 60 hours because we just didn't know what we were doing. We didn't know the equipment. We didn't know what we're going to get. We didn't know how to edit, you know. So all these skills, you know, we learned ourselves. And then when we understood what we were doing, because we didn't know at the beginning, we just had an idea and we just went with it. When we started to understand what we were doing, then it was like, okay, now we need to streamline this process. And how do you streamline this process? Okay, sometimes you got to bring other people in. Sometimes you got to make a, you know, a roadmap, you know. Actually, you should have a roadmap for everything, you know.
Exactly.
But my biggest advice is stick with it until you're sick of it, because I think finding your calling and your purpose is about what you don't want to do, finding out what you don't want to do, right? And so experimenting and being able to do these things allows you to figure out what is for you and what's not for you. And that's where me and Andre kind of maximized. It's like we were able to clearly delineate what we wanted to stay involved with, right? Like for me, been on the camera so much that I'm like, yeah, you know what? I kind of wanted to step away from being on camera and go behind the camera. But Andre was like, yeah, I like being on camera, you know? And so we developed this really interesting dynamic where, you know, we kind of just found our paths through that. And so I encourage everybody to just, if you see yourself creating content, just do it and then figure it out and streamline it, you know, sooner rather than later.
There you go. That's Alex. Like, I want to touch on a few points you mentioned here. You mentioned how a lot of episodes don't make it past 7. So if any of you new podcasters made past 7 episode, salute to you. Second thing you mentioned is that it's a collaborative thing. It's not something that you could do. You plan and that's exactly how y'all did it. And then also I want to lastly mention, you're the reason I started this whole podcasting thing. Having a vision board is super important, hence the name Vision Board Podcast. Appreciate it. I guess the new generation is going to be more interesting to see what y'all come up with. So I want to thank you, Alex, for your time. Shout out to your brother. Known him for a while. We went to school together. I went to school with you as well. And then shout out to Andre and the whole cast. And this is my appreciation. Like, I want to give you your flowers right now today. And just Alex, here's flowers, bro. And thank you. I hope you continue to do great things, big success. Can we wrap it up with like a special song here? Thank you for getting it done. Is there a tune that I can add to the outro for you, Alex?
Absolutely.
What would it be?
Special song? Oh, I have to pick?
Yeah. You can pick any song. So this is our famous segment where I ask people like, what song are you feeling? Are you feeling?
What song? Holy smokes. I think the song I would probably choose, it's probably Victory Lap by Nipsey Hussle.
Victory Lap by classic. All right. Thank you for getting it done, Alex. We're going to add that song to the outro. And how can people find you?
Yeah, I mean, you guys can find me. I'm on all social media platforms, Instagram, Twitter. It's always a flex on Instagram and TikTok as well. Twitter is AlexEHK. The Gifted Gab, we're in the middle of our rebrand, but it's TheGiftedGab.com. And The Gifted Gab across all social media platforms. We're on YouTube. Coach Omar Black will be premiering this fall.
Wow, big up.
I'm trying to get it to premiere in Toronto, so we're waiting to hear it back.
I'm there, bro. You make it, you bring it here, I'm there. All right. Thank you, Alex. Have a great rest of your day. Thank you for hopping on. You take care.
Later. Oh, man. Thank you.
Everybody can't go. Downtown Diamond District, jewelers like yo. Hustle, holla at me, I got Cubans on the low. Through to Cancun, smoking Cubans on the boat. Then dock that Tulum just to smoke. Look. Listening to music at the Mayan ruins. True devotion on the bluest ocean. Cruising. My cultural influence, even revolution. I'm integrated vertically, y'all. Blew it. They tell me hustle, dumb it down, you might confuse it. It's like that weirdo rap you motherfuckers choose to.